I don't know if you realized what is going on here, and I surely didn't when I flipped this rock. These are two separate colonies of Crematogaster ants living under the exact same rock, and when I flipped it, they started to intimidate and fight. Now, I didn't mean to do that, but I think putting the rock back in place immediately would have only made it worse. So I decided to wait a few minutes for the opponents to stop fighting, and I took these images. You can see that the sting is flattened and enlarged at the tip, allowing these ants to keep a droplet of venom at the end of the abdomen. They use it as strong repellent against other ant species and insects. They very rarely drop it on the cuticle of other ants, but if they do, the aldehydes and acetic acids contained in the venom can cause serious damages or even kill the other ant. In this case, it is rather unlikely that it will kill them, since Crematogaster ants have been shown to be resistant to their own venom. So you may wonder how these ants can keep such dangerous compounds in them. Well, they have two fully separated glands that produce non-toxic molecules. But when they mix these compounds in their sting, they react with each other and produce the toxic ones. So only the sting contains the toxic venom, and the ant does not have to get in contact with it. I hope you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe.